Now, it's time for Play School. And Play School today is presented by Carol Chell and Ben Bazell.
A house with a door. Windows, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ready to play? What's the day?
It's Thursday.
Hello. Have you ever been asked to sit still when really all you want to do is move about a little? Well, I have. By Carol.
Ben, sit still,
yes,
please.
Yes, Carol, sorry.
Hello. Ben, he must sit still,
yes,
because, you see, he's having his picture drawn, yeah, by Bill Tidy.
Hello.
And if he moves around, it's no good. You see, Bill, he is a cartoonist, and he draws for his work.
I'm still not happy about that. Everything's moving about. He's moving too much.
Oh, dear. You see, Ben, he's got to. Can't. Sit still. He just can't sit still. It's nothing to do. And he can't sit still. He looks up at the sky. He looks down at the floor. He looks left and right. And it's all such a bore when there's nothing to do but sit and stare. Can't sit still. He squirms in his chair. He twiddles his thumbs. He looks up and down. He scratches his head. He yawns. He frowns. He crosses his legs. He uncrosses them. And then, as he's nothing to do, he crosses them again. He fusses and fidgets. He wriggles until he's tied up in knots. He can't sit still. He just can't sit still. Oh, dear. How did you get on, Bill?
Carol, it's still a jumble. Look at this. Oh. Look at this. Look at it. Do you know, really, the only good picture I got was as he went away, I had a lovely picture of his big toe.
Oh! That's better. You can move about a bit now. Oh, loosen up a bit. You can move about a bit as well if you like. You can just shake a leg, shake an arm. Make any movement you like. Ready? Move with me. And let's all move together. Move together. Let's all move together. Move, move, move. Move, move this away. Move, move all the way. Move, move, move. Ah. Loosen up now. Few stretches. Oh. Join in with some stretches. If you know the tune, join in with the tune as well. Ready? And let's all stretch together. Stretch together. Let's all stretch together. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Stretch, stretch this away. Ah. Stretch, stretch that away. Ooh. Stretch, stretch every way. Ooh. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Ah. Ooh, that's better. Stretching makes you bigger. Squeezing makes you smaller. Try some squeezing movements for me. Ready? And let's all squeeze together. Squeeze together. Let's all squeeze together. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze this away. Squeeze, squeeze this away. Squeeze, squeeze every way. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze.
Here's something that stretches. Ooh. This great long spring. See, if I pull it out, it stretches and stretches. Ooh. Fold it up. See some other things that change. I'll put this tray up so you can't see and see if you can guess what these are. You're not looking, are you? Here's the first one. Now, if I've got it right, yes. Now, see if you can guess what this is. Now, what do you think that looks like? That's very thin. Like that. But if I turn it... See what happens? Now do you know what it is? That's a comb. Did you get that? I'll change it for something else. Now, try and be quiet. Right. See if you know what that is. What do you think it could be? I'll turn it round. It's a saucer. Did you get that one? Now. Something else. I have to get this the right way around. Right. Now, what could that be? Well, if I start to pull it out, it changes into a Christmas decoration. Did you get that one? And if I squash it back again, it's thin. Extremely thin, but if I pull and stretch it out and fix it with a hook or pin, it's fat, it's fat, it is extremely fat. Thin, fat, thin.
I'm thin, I am extremely thin. But if you pull and stretch me out and fix me with a hook or pin, I'm fat, I'm fat, I'm fantastically fat. And you can hang me on the wall to decorate your house or flat. I swing, I gaily bounce and swing, and make the place look bright and gay. But if you take my hook away, I'm thin, you can make fat or thin movements with me. Ready? Thin first, start very thin, and gradually get fatter, and fatter, fantastically fat, so fat you can hardly walk. Boom, 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 boom. Perhaps you could try swinging. Get a bit lighter. Bum 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 bum. Until you start to get thinner and thinner and thinner and thinner. Until you're as thin as can be.
What does your clock say?
Well, I'm sorry, I can't really tell you because the hands are so thick, I can't tell the time.
Well, Phil's going to tell a story today about a fat family and a thin family. But first, have a look at this clock. Do you know what time this clock's saying? Well, the long hand, that's pointing straight up to the 12, so that means it's something o'clock. And the short hand, that's pointing straight down to the number 6. And so today the clock says 6 o'clock. See what's underneath it today. Lots of food for a party.
For today is called What a Party, and I'm drawing it with this special pen on this special paper. And it's about the fat family and the thin family. Now, the fat family are fat because they live on fat food, whereas the thin family, look at the difference between them. The thin family live on little thin sandwiches, chips that look like that. And can you imagine a crisp that thin? That's what the thin family have. They also have a pet. The fat family have a tubby, cheerful tortoise. The thin family have a thin snail. They live in a fat house, do the fat family, with a nice heavy door and heavy curtains on the windows. But the thin family live nearby in a thin house with narrow windows and a narrow door. One day, the fat boy from the fat family met the girl from the thin family. And he said to her, "Let's have a party. Let's have a party with lots to eat and games, running and jumping games, and a table full of lovely food as prizes for games like musical chairs and that kind of thing." And the girl said, "Yes, we'll do that." So they had this lovely day, and they looked at the pies as the sun shone on them, and they started their games. Well, of course, thin people run faster than fat people. So, of course, they won all the prizes. The tortoise and the snail had a race as well, and the snail won. Now, the strange thing was that the prizes for the races with the food on the table. And Mr. Thin, while he was happy at winning all the races, suddenly noticed his clothes were getting a bit tight. And Mr. Fat began to be very upset because his lovely trousers, size 1,923, were now much too baggy for him. And his wife, who paid a lot of money for a dress, now it hung on her like someone standing inside a tent. Oh. And on the other side, Mr. Thin looked across to see if he could help, because he could hear everybody crying. But when he moved to help them, unbelievably, his socks split because he'd been eating all the food from the prizes. And his wife, his lovely slim wife, was terrified to move because her dress, which she paid so much money, was so tight that if she as much as breathed, it would split and show her knickers. Everybody was terribly upset. There were tears flowing and everybody was shouting, the children were crying, when suddenly two voices came up. They all looked down to see the tortoise and the snail. "Stop it, you silly people," they cried. For when they looked, the snail, who had not won any prizes, had swapped his shell with a tortoise, and he now had the tortoise shell. "Change your clothes, you silly people," they shouted. Of course, it was obvious. So Mr. Fat, with his big baggy trousers, ran off with his braces rattling in the wind to his house, only to find that when he got there, now that he was thin and weak, the heavy door on his house was too difficult to push open. It was a big, thick door. Whereas Mr. Thin, who now was huge, with his pants almost split down the back, When he ran back to his old house, the door was only that wide. He couldn't get in. Once again, a cheery voice shouted up. It was the snail. Change your houses like we did, he shouted. And they did. Mr. Finn, who was now fat, was quite happy to push open the door of that house. Mr. Fat, who was now thin, could slip quite easily into the other house and wave goodbye. They're going to have another party next year.
Very strange is going on here. Just look at the toys. Humpty, why can't you get a new trousers? What? You've eaten too much Christmas pudding. I see, you've put on a lot of weight then. Yes, I see you have. And Big Ted? Big Ted, you can't fit in your jumper. Hmm? You like trifle? Well, I know you do, but to eat so much. Goodness me, but Jemima? You must have lost weight. Why is that? Hmm? You've been doing a lot of disco dancing. You must have done. You've gone really thin. And who's this? Hamble, what are you doing under there? What? You're eating chocolates. Oh, Hamble, really? And little Ted. This is enormous. What? You've been jogging a lot. Oh, look, you know, I think they're playing a trick, don't you? What, Humpty? A cushion. Yes, there's a cushion here. Hmm? What? You want to jump on the cushion? Come on, I knew it was a trick. How are you going to jump with one leg in your trousers? Come on, then. Ready? Oh, Humpty. Now, careful, Humpty. No. Oh, Humpty. He meant to do that, didn't he? I don't know. What? Yes, come on, then. Ready, go! Oh! Oh, very good. Oh! He's exhausted. And you have a rest there then, Big Ted. Now, you should be good at this then, disco dancer. Come on. Oh, Jemima! You have lost weight. Dress fell off and... Come on, then. I don't think you can see, though, Hamble, can you? Come on. Oh. Oh. Come on, then, little Ted. Let's see what you can do.
In. Try another one. Oh, missed. Try this one. One. Oh, that missed. See how many I can get in. One, two, three. Three tiddlywinks in the paper plate. Through one of the windows today, you can see some other things, some different things that jump and bob around after they're being made. They're in the factory. Have a look through the arched window. Filling. It's mixed, squeezed out of holes. It starts off being quite gooey. It's called licorice. I wonder if you can guess what they're going to make. There's strips of licorice.
That stuff is called candy. That makes the other part of the sweet. Rolled out into sheets. And you can make sandwiches of licorice and candy. They're huge slabs of it there. And that's it cut up into smaller bits. Can you see what they are yet? Licorice all sorts.
Things hidden under these tiddlywinks. You shout out when you know what they are. Could be, who knows? There's something due any day. I will know right away, soon as it shows. It may come shooting like a star from the sky, flash from on high, coming to me. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something's good, if I can wait. Something's coming, I don't know what it is, but it is gonna be great.
With a click, with a shock, tiddlers jingle and they knock. Whose is that face? Someone's coming, I don't know who it is, but it is gonna be great.
Could be,
who knows?
Did you know who was coming?